you'd like to give to the audience?
Okay. I work in fitness and wellness and have for 38 years. Before that, I was a teacher working with children with disabilities. Children with disabilities I found by moving with them and working with on a level which many years ago people thought I was a witch because I was teaching them meditation in order to give them a sense of calm. And so I've continued doing that. I'm not a witch, and I absolutely believe quite strongly that everybody needs to have a balance in their life. My business is called Body in Balance. So I teach a fusion of yoga and Pilates and yoga nidra. And I'm going to corporate world, not all the time, but occasionally. And what I see in the corporate world, particularly with men, is they sit at a desk way too long. I talk about standing. I mean, it's difficult when you've got a really fast-paced job, and I know it is, that you need to get stuff done, you're on your computer, but the body just is so affected by what happens in your everyday work. Yeah, sitting up. Think of lengthening is fine. So I actually have a program I run called Keeping Your Working Mind and Body Fit. And I do talk about working with this kind of reflexology mat. If you do stand on the desk, you can actually take your shoes off and actually work all different parts of your body through your feet. You could sit on it. That would be fun. I work on all these different levels, and I find it has a profound difference for people once they start being aware of what their body's doing. So, for instance, turning to your right just gives yourself a little bit of a twist of the spine, but it also massages your spleen, as your liver to the right, it massages your spleen to the left, so you think of internal organs. When you sit like this, all sorts of things go wrong. So anyway, so I'm all about...
Right,
yeah. Being tall and lengthened, and I say it. Yeah, that's it. I say it, I teach kids as well, they go into school classes, and these high school girls are about, they're so tall, and they go, now think about the spine, lengthen out your body and stand tall, and I open my eyes, because I do it with eyes closed, open eyes, and I go, oh, what happened to me? It's so tall. But it's all about body and mind, but bringing it together, and I do it with the fusion of my body out. That's basically what I do.
That's enough of that. That's good. You've got everybody sitting up straight, we're awake, we're alert.
Okay, good on you, Jeff. I'm seeing a couple of my clients here as well, sitting up.
You
stand up. I've just, because I was discussing it, I was talking about, I do a lot of left-right brain stuff. People do a lot of left-right brain with their clients. And I've got different age groups. I actually work with children all the way through to aging adults. And I was saying one of my 85-year-old, who's probably the most amazing, 85-year-old who's been with me now for 20 years, had a breast removed this year, had all the treatment, continued. She said to me, I just need to have a little break off. She's come back. Now I teach a mix. I teach yoga and Pilates. I teach a fusion. And she said to me, one of the things is the fact that I've kept coming to classes, I've kept doing exercise. We all know that, don't we? If you stop, you lose it. Mm-hmm. Now, she's pretty amazing, but she said to me, she lives in a retirement village now. Her husband died and she couldn't keep up with her home anymore, but she said, I can't believe they don't move. So she asked me to come up and do some classes. Well, it was not particularly easy because most of them didn't want to get up out of their chairs, which is a bit sad actually. But looking at her, she's a living example of somebody who moves unbelievably. But the thing that she tells me that's helped her the most is the left-right brain balancing, which has really kept her very steady. And she said, all these old folks who are younger than her, they keep falling over. And I tell them, this is what you can do. She does this in the shower. I don't think it's great to do in the shower, but she does this in the shower. So what I'm going to do, and I do take it from, there's a whole lot of things that I do. So I'm talking about core yesterday as well. So I get core engaged to start with. It's really important because one of the aspects of core is it helps you with your balance. So if you've got actually weak core muscles, your posture actually changes, as you probably all know. Back changes, weakens through here, the length of your legs, everything changes if your muscles are weak, the core muscles, the centre. So I'll just do a little bit, which is what I do in every single class with every age group, is finding hip distance apart. And as you were saying yesterday, some people are out there, you go, well, okay then, that's how you feel comfortable. But feeling heels, balls of feet and toes, and just drop the arms down. Always I do a little movement too. Always a little shake, get your body into some sort of, and then bring yourself back into equilibrium if you can. Dropping your arms, drop your shoulders, and closing eyes. And again, if that's too strong, if that's too much for you, closing your eyes and you feel dizzy, you open your eyes straight away. But closing your eyes and take a deep breath. Now I'm going to do a Pilates breath, which is an inhale through the nose and an exhale. And if you want to even do that with a slight sigh.
Exhale through the mouth.
Mouth, sorry, yes. You will feel that the abdominal muscles will start to contract. And breathing out through the mouth. Now loosen that imaginary belt from your 10th hole to your 9th, 8th, 7th, 6th, 5th, 4th and 3rd hole. So we're 30% abdominals, 30% pelvic floor, and this is actually really good if you can think of 30% of that 100%. You think of that anywhere, walking, sitting, standing, whatever you're doing. 30% is a really good indication that you are engaging the core. You don't need to be gripping, no gripping. 30% is great. Then we're coming up to the lungs. We're going to fill up the lungs. Take a deep breath. And imagine you're filling up each space between your ribs. We're not trying to push the lungs forward or push out through the ribs. So broaden the rib cage as you breathe out. So again, you might want to place your hands up there. So inhale. Try not to push forward. And as you exhale, broaden. Broaden the rib cage all the way around, so to feel that broadened effect rather than push forward. And doing that actually helps, from what I believe, and I might ask you, but what I believe takes more oxygen into the lung capacity by broadening the rib cage rather than pushing forward. Drop the shoulders, drop the arms down. Take a breath in, bring the shoulders right up under the ears. As you breathe out, we're going to roll those shoulders and drop them down towards the shoulder blades and form a V shape into your back. And again, lift up, inhale. Exhale and drop. Now lengthen your neck. I actually do quite a different few things here. It's like taking the ear to the shoulder if you wish. Just still with your eyes closed, not shoulder to ear. Back to the center and just take the ear towards the other shoulder. Try not to bring the shoulder to ear, but ear to shoulder. And then just back to the center. Now if you've still got your eyes closed and you start to feel dizzy with this, just open your eyes. But inhale and turn your head to one side. And then exhale, come back to the center. Inhale, turn to the other side. And if you're feeling dizzy, please open the eyes. Exhale, back to the center. Now think of lengthen neck, crown of head to ceiling. Now we're going to challenge our balance with our core muscles switched on. So inhale again. As you exhale, tighten your imaginary belt somewhere between 50 and 70%. So we're going to switch on the core and with eyes closed, if you can, rise up onto your toes. So now we're focusing on your breath, your balance, and your concentration. Drop back down again. Take the weight back onto the heels, balls of the feet, lift the toes up again. And if you're fine with your eyes closed, keep them closed. Inhale again, tighten the imaginary belt, somewhere between 50 and 70. Breathing out, contracting abdominal muscles, and lengthen spine, crown of head to ceiling, and balance. Drop back down, take your weight back onto heels, balls of the feet. And then breathe in. We're going to open the eyes this time, drawing into the abdominals, reaching up. Now if you feel that's too strong, you can keep the arms down, but if you're fine with the balance, look at you, beautiful balanced people. Take a breath in, dropping down. Breath out, rising back up, drawing into the abdominals, so helping that balance. And then dropping back down, take one more breath, knees as soft as you drop down, and breath out, lifting up. Okay, so from there I would be going into some thoracic turns, a few different things, but that's sort of how I get the class, my class has started, where I will do, yeah, lots of nice little twists. I actually go into a bit of a dance to tell you the truth, but we're going to draw up through, we've still got our pelvic floor just a little bit switched on. So, left, right brain balancing comes through I do a whole lot of other stuff by the time I get to this, but we'll go from this one. So if you all take your right leg forward, I've got my left, so we're just doing a mirror for me. You will know this position. Bring your hands to your hips and squaring the hips off. Bring your left heel up, drop it down. So we've got a little hip flexor stretch happening as well. Breath out. Now, breathing in, again, your abdominals contract slightly on that breath out. And breath in again. So we're going to come down into a lunge or a warrior one. Extend the arms. It's up to you with your arms, shoulders. This is where we're talking different age groups, of course. If it's too much to have the arms all the way up, you can keep them on your shoulders. You can keep them dropped down beside you. I'm going to turn so you can actually see what I'm doing. And we're breathing in. We're lengthened. We're drawing into the abdominals as you breathe out. And if you have any issues with the knees, make sure you can see your toes beyond your right knee. So we're not putting too much stress on the knees. Now, take a breath in. I'm going to take the arms out to the side now as you breathe out. Take another breath in. We're going to really focus on balance here. As you breathe out, draw into the abdominal muscles. Bring your left leg up. Okay, we hold it there. We're going to lift up for three, two. We're all right with our arms out there. Two, one. Now, extend the leg. So you'll know all these. It's a fusion of yoga and Pilates I'm doing. So bend it again. So three of those. So we're balancing. You can soften your knee if you like, the supporting leg. And extend. Now hold your left knee. Take your right arm up above the crown of your head. Now I use little balls here. They're coloured balls, called chi balls, about this big. I've got the balls. And I think I say straight up, think of that as though you've got a halo, a moon above your head. Take a breath in. We're going to open into the hip. You're going to take your left leg to the side. And as you do, you've got the ball in your hand or the palm of your hand. You're going to turn and look as you breathe out. So you can see there's a lot of focus, there's a lot of balance. And this is my 85-year-old woman in the shower, she says. Come back, take a breath in. Breath out and turn again. Breathing out. Switch on the core muscles. Looking towards your right hand, or if you had a little ball, looking to the ball. Take a breath in again. If you find this is too strong, soften your knee. Or you might want to drop down, modified version. You can take the toe to the floor and just take it to the side. That's the modified version.
Done that, you can do modifications. Well, most things you can do modifications. It is getting a bit cold, isn't it? Do you know what's just happened? It started raining, I think.
Oh,
you feel the change in the weather. Everyone feeling cold. We don't have heaters in here, too, pity. Have you got another top, maybe?
Oh, I have a jacket, yeah. You should be right with your clothes.
Okay, yeah. Actually, it's funny you should do that because I've looked at it and I thought, well, probably should close it off. All right, so I've given, it's going to a basic class where you can have modifications. Okay, so from here, I'm going to get you to take another breath in and lift one leg to a tabletop. So by tabletop, it's 90 degrees hip to knee is tabletop and in an L shape. It. Lower that leg back down, take a breath in, lifting the other leg as you breathe out. Now, think of core muscles again. So you're going to breathe in, lower the leg, breath out, contract abdominals, and lift. And on the breath out through the mouth. Lower again, take a breath in, and lifting the other leg, breath out. Now keep that leg there, this is up to you with your backs, see how you feel. Breathe in again, keep the leg there, take the other leg out. So you've got two legs in tabletop. If your back starts to then suddenly feel as though you've got some pulling going on, you need to think about keeping one foot on the floor. Is that what happened? Okay. So with one foot, you're okay? All right. From there, take a breath in. This is how I'm going to get used to it. You're going to tip one toe to the floor. Everybody with their both legs up. Tip a toe to the floor. Breath out. Lift it back up again. So I'm going to just get you to alternate. So drop and then lift. Okay? So tip a toe and lift. Tip a toe, breath out, and then lift. And again, tip and lift, and tip and lift. Now, see if you can tip both toes, which you can continue alternating. All right, so what happens to your back? Does anything change? Did you take yourself out of neutral? You did? Did your back go like that?
Yes.
So the idea then, you don't touch the floor. All right, so your toes won't touch the floor. So just tip, breath out. Or tip if you can, or go towards tip. You're all right? So feeling strong. So what happens here? You've got to hold nice and strong so that you don't do this. Okay, but you're, because you've got that lordotic thing already, and that's why it happens. Two more of those. One more. And then hug your knees to your chest. Now, anyone find that went into their back straight away? Apart from you?
So, I mean, these are really, this is quite, you know, not too difficult, quite easy to run through with kids. I'm usually like, four, and they all get to know me so well, they know what's coming next. In fact, your girls from McKellar are brilliant. They're just so spot on, it's like they just get it straight away. Really, really good. Okay, we're not all schools, do not all kids. Most of them don't know they're left or right. But place the feet back on the mat again, all right? We're going to try this, take the hands to the back of the head. Supported head, if you don't need to, if you don't have to lift your head if you don't need to. One leg to tabletop, other leg to tabletop, and I'll get you just to do single leg extension. So what we're going to do here is take a breath in and extend your right leg. So if you could just do, so you can kick the foot on the floor, this one on the floor, and knees are bent, and then just extend your right leg. Yeah, just do that. So I'll get you doing that. If you can lift your head and shoulders, do so. This is called single leg stretch. We're going to change over. Take a breath out, and your head and shoulders are lifted. So I'll just show you what I'm talking about. If you can't keep the head and shoulders lifted, not to worry. So it's this, breath out. We go 10, 9, 8, 7, like that. Okay? So we come on up, head and shoulders, and let's go. Let's go for 10, breath out, 10. I've usually got pumping music as well. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, yay. Okay, hug the knees to your chest. I do a lot of yay and woos and things with the kids. Feet to the mat. I actually do it all with my adults as well. Feet to the mat, but you're still lying down. Interlock the fingers, hands to the back of the head again. Lift the head and shoulders. Lift one leg, lift the other, and I'll get you to keep one foot on the floor. Extend your right leg. Take your right elbow to your left knee, but truly probably not. Okay? So what we